guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Desi, and yes, I know I've been gone for a while, but I'm back and I got a story time for y'all. But if you haven't already, go ahead and like, comment, share, subscribe, you know, be a part of the perky gang. And yo, so this is my story time. Before I start, it's a long video. I got a lot to talk about. If I can't get it within 15 minutes, I'm going to have a part two. But yeah. So, if y'all really know me, like, oh, if y'all hear it in the background, it's my fish tank. But people, the real OGs that actually know me, know I ain't never been in a relationship, like a real relationship, like, you know, booed up, all that. I ain't never had none of that. But I've experienced stuff, and like, I've had options, and like, I've talked to people. So I know, you know, I know game, I know a little bit. But it just is one particular person that has me confused, and it keep running through my mind. So like, let me just talk it out, you know, see what y'all think about it. But y'all, so let's get right into it. So I am 17 now. So this started when I was finna turn 16, so I was 15, about, I guess, 2 years ago. I had went to Atlanta, you know, go get a background story. I was in Atlanta with my friend. We celebrated my birthday. And, you know, it was, like, time for us to go to sleep. So, we was in the hotel. I got kind of lonely. Not lonely, but, you know, like, you know how y'all just be sitting there laying in the bed. You be like, dang, like, I ain't got nobody to talk to. You know the vibe. You know what I'm talking about. So, I was on Instagram. And I'm just scrolling through pictures, just liking stuff. And I'm like, somebody told me, like, just pull up, like, cute boys or something. So, I went to some girl page that's from, like, around here. Well, not from around here, but, like, probably 30 minutes away. It don't matter. And I just seen this boy here, like, there was stuff. And I was like, he's cute. So, I went to his page, and I liked his. Well, I didn't like it, but, like, I looked at it. And I was like, he cute. And his Snapchat happened to be in his bio. So, you know, me being me, I'm like, I'm bored. I'm finna just hit this person up. So, I went to his Snap, and I was like, hey. And I was like, you cute. And all that. So, he texts back instantly, fast. And he was like, hey, he was like, you too. No, he was like, you fine, something like that. You know, I had to post a picture on Snap. It was like about 1 o'clock in the morning. But you know, like, once you ask somebody, you gotta go ahead and post your picture so they can see how you look. Something like that. Y'all get it. So I did that. He texted me back. He was like, yeah, you cute and everything. So, you know, we went doing a little, you know, the regular talk, you know, where you from, how old are you, and woot woot, all that. So I had did that. And he was like, I'm from blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to say where, but it's like literally 25 minutes away. And I was like, oh, okay. Because y'all know, like, people usually on Snapchat are not around here. So, like, you'll be talking to somebody, be like, I'm from Cali. And be like, dang, like, you fine. You live so far away. But this dude live right around the corner. I was like, okay, this was so, like, yeah. So, you know, we just have a normal conversation. I mean, good combos. I mean, back to back to back to back. He tapped back fast. I tapped back fast. He, you know, responded first. All that. Tested it whole night. Finally went to sleep. And I was like, all right, I'm talking to you later. He texted me the next morning. I said, this is my old phone. I was like, what? So, I responded back, you know, kept conversation going, you know, just asking about stuff. You know, real conversation, all that. Actually, no, we didn't even have none of that conversation. We just had real life conversations. And I was like, yeah, I'm celebrating my birthday. I'm in Atlanta. Like, you know, just real conversation. So, fast forward a little bit. We get to talking every day, like, every day. Probably, I want to say for a good month. And it was like the real conversation. So, in this generation, for some people, I know boys are expected to text, but not all the time, but they are expected to engage in conversations. So, like, you know, the girls can have something to say, which he was doing it, like, he was getting everything on point. I mean, looks, the way he talked, all that. So, okay, mind y'all, go back a little bit. This was on Snapchat, so I'm saying video chatted. We video chatted probably, I want to say only 3 times, and that was it. I ain't see his face. I haven't seen him in person ever. But I seen his face like 3 times. But like, I mean, if we having good conversations and I know you're not a catfish, it's okay. Well, in my head, my job. I'm a real deep overthinker. Y'all gonna understand me as soon as I finish these. If I follow me this, okay. But yeah, back to what I was saying. So, yeah, we get the texting and stuff. He texts me every day, you know, everything going good, boom, boom, boom. And then I moving too fast, but I mean, I just want to say, I was like, would you F with me? Not F, but like, y'all know what I'm talking about, like, would you talk to me, like, talk? He was like, yeah, I'll F with you. And I was like, okay, cool, you know what I'm saying? Spin my game a little bit. I ain't got no game, but I tried. So, you know, I did that. And then I get moving a little bit too much fast. And I think about it, I was young, you know, young and dumb. I wasn't dumb. I'm highly intelligent. But I just want to tell y'all, see, y'all, these generation play with y'all. This is why I never had a relationship, because y'all generation, my generation is messed up. Like, when I want something, I'm going to act like I want it. Like, I'm not going to pretend, and I'm going to tell you, I'm going to engage, I'm going to do everything it takes. You know, big simp, not a mobile, but big simp back then. So, I was like, oh, okay, cool. We get talking. Then, you know, come say start, and it went from whoop in here, it went down a little bit. So I started, you know, I didn't notice all of these, you know, maybe hints or signs. When I tell y'all I was brainwashed, I didn't notice none of this. I was just going with the flow, but, you know, trying to add a little ink to it, like, you know what I'm saying, add a little depth to it. So I started, since he started lacking on, like, talking first and everything. So I was like, okay, well, I'm gonna be, you know, different. Like, he probably think I'm a regular girl. Like, I gotta show him I'm a different girl. I ain't like the other girl. So y'all know the little big emoji things that be inside the text message and Snapchat? I started sending that, and I was like, good morning with my big emoji. No, y'all understand what I'm saying. If you don't, oh well, look up big emoji. I started doing that, you know, being extra, sending gifts, not gifts, but the gifts through the messages, is being freaking extra, talking in French. I don't even know what French is, but I try, you know, razzle-dazzle the conversation. Being extra, like I said, hella extra. And he was going into, you know, I was like, oh, like, this your favorite cartoon? You know, this is my favorite cartoon, too. Like, vibes, just vibe. So he dilated, just kept dilating. And then it got to a point, I was like, so when we gonna meet? And it's like, okay, so I didn't really know him, but from like what he told me from that point at the time, his schedule was kind of iffy. So like, and plus he worked. I don't want to give out too many details, but like, I mean, it's true. So yeah, it got iffy. So we kind of stopped talking, but because I think I asked, and I was like, okay, so if you like me, like, you'll text me tomorrow, you know, making, like they said, don't tell a man how to treat you, or don't tell a boy how to treat you, because they're not already doing it, it's not right. Boom, I'm not thinking. So I was like, yeah, text me tomorrow if you're my friend, or like, text me tomorrow. Telling him to engage in it instead of waiting for him to do it himself, but I already knew he was going, okay, y'all gonna remember what I said now. I already know how this dude, like, texts, like, I'm a fast, I pick up on small things. So he the type that, especially if he don't know me, he always call me a stranger, but we'll get into that later. Like, if he don't know you, like, he's not gonna, you know, do all this stuff. And then I'm trying to jump too far ahead, but what was I? So yeah, find out, he didn't text me the next day. I waited a whole week, I didn't get a response, I didn't get nothing. I was like, dang, I just got played. But his birthday was coming up, like, in 2 more months. I was like, okay, maybe I'll hit him back up on his birthday. So boom, 2 months passed, my birthday came. I was like, happy birthday. And I had a little conversation. I was like, how you doing? How, like, you know, what you doing on your birthday? Had a little combo. That was it. Stopped texting again for like another month and a half. Yeah, he just kept going through my head. So I kept going back. And we wasn't together, but I kept going back to him. But you know what I'm saying? I kept texting him. I don't know why. So I think February came on Valentine. I was like, happy Valentine Day. And he was like, Valentine Day to you too. You know, had a little smaller conversation, and boom, that was it. Then fast forward again, my birthday came out. Mind y'all, tell me why the dates kept adding up. And last year, I first started talking on my birthday, the 2 days before my birthday. And then this year, when I talked to him again, it was 2 days before my birthday. My birthday came around, and I was like, hey, how you doing? You know, just trying to keep in contact. You know what I'm saying? Not trying to say nothing, but trying to keep in contact. And we got to text him for like a while. But it wasn't him. I was really engaged in the combo because, like, I mean, I don't expect for him to engage the combo, especially if I came to him first. So, I was texting for a while. And I could tell that he done changed since like last year and this year, because like the way you're speaking is different. Like I said, I could see, I got 5 minutes left. I'm gonna do a part two, but yeah, the way you speaking, I could tell it's different. So yeah. And I, you know, once again, I ignored it, but like it'll be like one day, like the combo going real good. Like I'm not tell y'all, I was pre-planning every conversation. I went on my notes, I went to Google, I typed in. Mostly I talked about like stories about me. Like I'm like, okay, like this happened in my life, and like, yeah, this was a story time. I was doing story times to him. Mind you, we never got on the phone, never did FaceTime, none of that. We just texting. So I was doing like story times through texts, and then he'll tell me something about him, you know, back and forth, like tag, you know, all that. And I once again asked him, I was like, is like he messing with anybody? Cause like, I really like you. This dude is fine and fine as wine. Let me stop being corny. But he was something I was interested in. So I shot my shot again. And you know, I'm doing school. He said he'll send me good mornings. You know, we'll talk the whole day, like the whole day. But they, like some people I said, they said, some people that I've known, they said that dudes don't really know how to initiate a conversation, so like the girls do it. So I mean, I ain't mind doing it. So you know, I make the conversation every day as long as he texts me first. Then it got to the point where I was the only one that texted good morning. It took him a long time. Well, no, really, he was real good at texting back, but like, you know, time fly by and then started getting iffy again. So I was like, okay, so can we, no, let me not go too far. I was saying things like, I'm a real overthinker, like I said. So like when I tell somebody about my what's the thing called, about like I was talking about the government, like my theories and like real scientific like stuff, like made me sound like a nerd, but like it's like real stuff. I get to talk about it and he the calling me crazy and I'm like psycho and like I need mental health. He didn't say mental health, but he'll call me crazy, not like no crazy like how y'all be thinking. I mean like psycho crazy. That's how he was. I mean, maybe I am crazy, but I was starting to pick up a vibe to where like, say we were together, if I would start saying this stuff, it would kill his vibe and we won't vibe no more. You know what I'm saying? But I need somebody I can talk real stuff to, and it wasn't that. But I still played along with it, you know, killing gate and stuff. I may screenshot a few messages so y'all can understand what I'm saying. I mean, it may be part two, part three, because I'm running out of time, but yeah. And well, his conversation go from like 100 to like 10 real quick, you know what I'm saying? Because he'll be saying some like good stuff. Like what I really was trying to do was to get him to trust me. And for the things he was telling me, like with his past relationships, I guess he said his ex-girlfriend argued too much or something like that. And then like, you know, you have to see like what type of dudes you're working with. Like if they like in the streets or like, you know, going through mental problems, like with him, not trying to put too much out there about his life, but his parents aren't around. Not gonna tell you why, but his parents not around. So he basically grew up with somebody else and he's going through problems. So maybe like that, and maybe with his old relationships, maybe he did all the things that I was expecting early on. And since he doesn't know me, you know, he was like, I'd be a dumb N-word if I do that, you know what I'm saying? So I respected that. So I was like, okay, cool, maybe we could just keep being friends until, you know. But I kept initiating that I liked him, but like when I say it, he'll be like, because when I asked him, I'm gonna show you a screenshot. When I asked him, I was like, do you even like me? And he was like, he said his exact words, he was like, if I didn't like you, not even a little bit, I wouldn't even be texting you, like, I wouldn't even be doing all this with you. And I was like, oh, okay, so to me, you do like me, do you know? He never gave me like a one-word answer. It was always whatever you say, or it doesn't matter, it's up to you. Like, I'm asking you, dude, like, give me something to work with, because I don't know what I'm doing. Like, and I tell y'all, I was ticked off, but it was just something about this dude. And then, mind y'all, I just always pray to God. I was like, God, give me somebody I can save, like, somebody, like, I can grow with. Like, I don't, like, if they going through something, like, I want to be that person that somebody can lean on. Like, that's my, because, like, you know, if you be a blessing to somebody else, lessons will come to you. And he was in a position where I can save. Well, I thought I could save. I mean, I can save. But he just, I guess he just don't want to be saved. Don't save her. She don't want to.